death. Holy Week started with the triumphal entry into Jerusalem, which shouts, "A Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." This was followed by Jesus teaching in the temple and being challenged by those who were.
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and make preparations for us to eat the Passover." "Where do you want us to prepare for it?" they asked. He replied, "As you enter the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him to the house that he enters, and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is the room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, all furnished. Make preparations there." They left and found things just as Jesus had told them. So they prepared the Passover. When the hour came, Jesus and his disciples reclined at the table. And he said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God." And he took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you."
Come and die, peace of bread, I take all.
After the meal with his disciples in the upper room, Jesus walked with his disciples. He said, "You will all desert me this very night, so it is written by the prophet Zechariah, 'Strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.'" Peter told him, "Even if everyone falls away because of you, I will never fall away." "Truly I tell you," Jesus said to him, "tonight, before the rooster crows, you will deny me 3 times. "Even if I had to die with you," Peter told him, "I will never deny you." And all the disciples said the same thing. Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he told the disciples,
arrested him.
in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook, the rocks split, and the tombs broke open. When the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, "Surely he was the Son of God."